Hello, friends. Welcome to another episode of Amaze Your Brain at Home. My name is Julian. I'm a tech truck educator with the Perot Museum of Nature and Science. This week, it's all about paleontology, the scientific study of ancient life. Now, in this video, I will show you how you get to be your own paleontologist with your own museum that you get to curate with your own specimens using a website called TinkerCAD. TinkerCAD is a computer-aided design website that allows you to experiment with 3D modeling and 3D design. Now, before we get into all of that, my friend Kenzie, who really likes animals, especially ancient animals, is going to help me out with this conversation a little bit and explain why paleontology is important and why it's important for all realms of science. How about it, Kenzie?
Thanks, Julian. So paleontology is so important because it tells us how life has formed over time. So the life that we have today, it took some time to get there and it didn't always look the same. So we use paleontology to learn more about life today. We use it for taxonomy, which is how we classify different organisms. This could include plants and animals as well. It also helps scientists understand how different rocks and minerals have formed over time. Another thing to think about is that extinction isn't just a thing of the past. A lot of animals are actually really close to becoming extinct. So I want to show you one of my favorite animals in the world. I actually have an illustration from 1956. So this right here is called a thylacine. So this animal actually had ancestors that looked very similar to it. They were very large marsupials with very similar stripes, but they made this guy look pretty puny. Something that I really encourage you guys to look into is there's actually footage of these animals in zoos in the early 1900s. You can see them walking around, they have a really wide mouth. There's all different kinds of really cool footage that we actually get to learn from today. So even though we didn't get to see these animals back in their prime, we have some video footage that scientists like to study. Wouldn't it be nice if we had video footage of animals like dinosaurs or other things that we'd like to study? So that's why we have to look to fossils or paleontology to learn how they lived back then.
Thank you, Kenzie. I've been thinking a lot about what Kenzie said when it comes to extinct species and what we as scientists can do in order to learn more about them. Paleontologists use a variety of different tools and techniques in order to further their research, one of which includes 3D scanning and 3D printing. How does a 3D scanner work? One of the methods that paleontologists use to capture a 3D scan is by using a laser scanner. A laser scanner uses a combination of cameras and laser projectors in order to capture the shape of an object. This is especially helpful when paleontologists are handling delicate specimens or if they want to share their specimen with another scientist or researcher. The Triceratops that you see on your screen is an example of a 3D model that TechTruck was able to download and 3D print using one of the 3D printers on hand. Cool, huh? What if there was a way for you to be your own paleontologist and to curate a museum with your own extinct or ancient animals? I'm going to show you that today by using TinkerCAD. TinkerCAD is an online CAD software, CAD standing for computer-aided design. By using simple shapes and learning how to manipulate them, and being able to import 3D models of ancient and extinct animals, you can create your own virtual museum. What we're looking at right now is my version. What we need your help with is completing the scavenger hunt list that is uploaded along with this video on the Amaze Your Brain at Home website. Once you have completed the scavenger hunt, I want you to make your own virtual museum. If you would like to be your own paleontologist and curate your own virtual museum, stay tuned for a quick crash course on TinkerCAD. Start off by opening a browser and going to tinkercad.com. Once you do that, you will either click sign in if you have an account already, or you can create an account by clicking on join now. Make sure to obtain parents' permission before doing so. Once you have logged in, click on Create New Design. Once you have your design open, go ahead and click on the name that is already pre-populated and change it to something that you like. So I'm going to change it to Julian's Museum and click somewhere off to the side. You're going to start off by learning the basics of the mechanics of TinkerCAD. Start off by clicking and dragging using your left click on your mouse, click and drag the box onto the screen right in the middle. When you let go of the mouse, you will see a bunch of things pop up around the box. Click and drag one of the white boxes to see what happens. You can change the shape and the size of your box. You can also click somewhere on the red part using your left click on your mouse, click and drag to move your object. You can also click and drag on the center white box so you can make it really tall or really short. You can also hover over the little arrows on the side if you would like to rotate it this way, or you can rotate it that way also. And then finally, hover your mouse over the cone that's right in the middle, hold and click on your left mouse to drag it up or below your work plane. You can also change the perspective or the way you see your workspace by holding down on the right click button, hold down on it, and drag to change your perspective to see how you can see your model differently. If you would like to return how you were before originally, click on the little house on the side right there. Now that you have learned the basic mechanics of how to use TinkerCAD, let's go find some 3D models of animals to put in our museum. Click on the TinkerCAD logo in the top left corner. Once you have done that, click on the magnifying glass in the top right corner. Click on the Show Me part where it says Designs or People. You can either type in Tech Truck, 3D Museum, or Perot Museum, but make sure that they are all one word with no spaces. Then hit Enter. Now you will see several different options for starting your museum. The file that says all 3D museum animals has all of the animals that I have available on TinkerCAD. I also have my 3D museum available in case you just want to complete the scavenger hunt. If you would like to copy the animals that I have posted onto your museum, click on the file and then click on Copy and Tinker. It might take a few minutes for all of the files to load onto your workspace. Once all of the files have been loaded, then you have your animals ready to go. If you would like to select some of the animals to move out of the way so you have room on your workspace, just use your left click mouse to click and drag over so you can highlight all of these items here, and then you can move them out of the way so that you have more space to work on. Start off by building a floor, maybe build some stairs, build some kind of way to support all of the specimens that you have available, and just have fun with it. And make sure to tag your museum with 3D Museum or Perot Museum so that we can also get to see how your museum's turned out. I even was able to put a thylacine in my museum that I created so that other people can learn about this extinct species. I would also like to thank Duke University for providing some of the 3D models available on morphosource.org as well as thingiverse.com. Thank you guys for joining me on this episode of Amaze Your Brain at Home. Again, my name is Julian, and thank you to my friend Kenzie for helping out as well. See you guys next time. Bye.